superintendents across the state, we came up with license plates. And there are 9 particular schools that have individual bills for state of Ohio license plates. They will be considered vanity plates, so there will be an upcharge of $40 on those plates of the 9 schools. $10 will be retained by the BMB, and $30 will go directly to the schools. And that $30 shall only be used for one purpose, and that purpose is the emotional and well-being of their student body. So the president or the superintendent shall decide what programs do they need for the well-being of their student body, because there might be different needs from high school all the way to grade school. So it could be bereavement, it could be talking about drugs, it could be suicide prevention, it could be sensitivity training, could be about human trafficking. But the authority and the decision-making will be made by the administrators of the school and counselors as to what is needed for their particular school. And the statewide bill will be House Bill 323. And as you're looking at all these different initiatives, there are other initiatives that perhaps you can just do in your own neighborhood. And one of those initiatives could be just a box. Because we need to have tools in the toolbox, and whatever a child feels comfortable in utilizing, that is what we should make available to them. So this is what my family does, and we give these boxes to schools, to churches, to rec centers, to any place that children gather. It's a locked box, and whoever gets the box, they will read the notes that are inside, it is locked, and they make the commitment that they will check that every day. And there have been cases where they have received information that someone was going to harm themselves. And they got the information beforehand and stopped it. So these are just other initiatives that you can do. Next, I would like to have Dr. Horton come up from NEOMED.
Thank you so much, Representative Anielski. I'm just so proud to be here today talking about this new legislation that is focused on suicide prevention on our college and university campuses across Ohio. You know, this is legislation championed by Representative Anielski, but so many others have been involved, and we see folks here on the stage representing universities, the Ohio regions, the Department of Higher Education, and many other constituencies across Ohio coming together to champion these very important types of legislation. And this is a significant legislation that is being enacted. As this bill is implemented and we begin to see the requirements of this bill take fruition on our college and university campuses, we're going to see the best practices disseminated on these campuses, best practices designed to raise awareness among students about mental health issues, about suicide prevention. And I think others, you know, have spoken eloquently about the issue that we're talking about here today in a couple of forums. You know, these are issues that sort of start with the university, with the campuses, with the students. But you know, they're also community issues. They're also issues spreading across the entire state. And frankly, this is a national issue that we're dealing with. And if there's any evidence that you might need for that, I don't know if any of you saw this, but this is the front page of the Chronicle of Higher Education from September 4th, 2015, this past Friday. And the lead article is Today's Anguished Students. And this looks across the entire nation at what's happening on our college and university campuses. And it talks about 58% of campuses have seen a rise in anxiety disorders among students. 89% of campuses have seen a rise in clinical depression. And quite starking is the fact that 8% of students across the colleges and universities of our nation in the past past 12 months have seriously considered suicide. So we have done some great things. There are great things going on, and there's still work to be done. And that's really what we're talking about today, is moving forward with some great initiatives. So I think what I'd like to do just very briefly is talk about what's happening in NEOMED and talk about how this new legislation and funding is really going to allow that work to move forward. So, you know, we're a health sciences university, and part of our mission is to conduct research, is to discover new knowledge, but most importantly, to apply that knowledge for the good of folks in our region, our communities, and across the state. And when it comes to suicide prevention, to campus safety and mental health, this has been an area that NEOMED has focused on for quite some time, for almost 10 years. We've been looking at issues related to campus safety and student mental health. Largely, the work that we're talking about is happening in our Department of Psychiatry at NEOMED, which is chaired by Dr. Martin Metz. And within that department are many programs that are being conducted focused on these issues. Probably the principal program that I would mention today, because it's so related to the new bill and to the funding, is what we call the Ohio Program for Campus Safety and Mental Health. I think this program really reflects both the type of issue we're dealing with, but more importantly, the type of solutions that we know we must find for these issues, because it represents a program that is across the entire state of Ohio. Even though NEOMED is the home or the hub of this program, really it's been designed to acquire funding and then to disseminate that funding across the state. So over the last 5 years, for example, NEOMED has acquired over $180,000 of funding from various sources, state sources, philanthropic sources, and then used those dollars to ask individual campuses, colleges, universities to put their best ideas forward about how they can impact awareness of suicide prevention and student mental health on their campus, and then disseminate those dollars out. So in the last 5 years, that $180,000 has went out to 50 colleges and universities across the state of Ohio, for all colleges, the public universities, the private nonprofits, community colleges, technical colleges, and allowed those universities and colleges to customize these programs for their own needs. So 50 colleges and universities across the state of Ohio, all working together to try to understand best practices in this area.